visionOS 26 will enable groundbreaking new spatial experiences in your apps and games. This year brings an extensive update with new volumetric APIs, advanced sharing capabilities, exciting immersive media tools, and powerful enterprise features. Now, enhancements across new and existing SwiftUI APIs make it even easier to build compelling volumetric experiences. You can create even richer 3D layouts in the same familiar way as 2D UI. Layouts are now aware of visual effects like rotation. Existing APIs allow you to easily align your views within volumes. You can align overlapping content in the same 3D space with Spatial Container, or anchor content to specific locations with 3D anchor preferences, all in Swift UI. Dynamic bounds restrictions allows you to draw outside your app's bounds in both volumes and windows with a simple view modifier. And environment occlusion makes it so virtual objects can be occluded by static real-world objects. You can bring this behavior to your apps by adding an environment blending component to any entity. Now, a new suite of APIs deepen the integration between SwiftUI, RealityKit, and ARKit. It is easier to position and translate content across these three fundamental frameworks, regardless of the coordinate space you're working in. RealityKit's entity and its animations are observable, allowing them to be used directly in SwiftUI views. You can directly apply gestures to entities, or present and animate 3D content in your app with Model 3D. Because many of the best spatial experiences are shared, visionOS 26 introduces a new capability. With nearby window sharing, you can build shared spatial experiences for users located in the same room, like Rock Paper Reality's Defenderella, as well as bring in remote participants using FaceTime and spatial personas. New SharePlay APIs make adoption even easier, and your existing SharePlay apps will automatically work. ARKit also adds support for shared world anchors, so you can precisely anchor shared content to the room. In visionOS 26, apps and quick look content persist or reappear in the same place, even after restart. This behavior is also coming to widgets. The familiar WidgetKit framework, along with new APIs to specify its texture or react to users' proximity, are now available, allowing you to build dynamic widgets that persist throughout users' spaces. Around the world, users love experiencing content on Vision Pro, and now they have an incredible new way to experience photos. RealityKit's image presentation component can be used in your app to transform 2D images into 3D spatial scenes, leveraging on-device generative AI algorithms to create a 3D representation of your image, optimized for real-time rendering from multiple points of view. If you are building media applications, you can play and distribute even more types of immersive content with built-in support for 180-degree, 360-degree, and wide field of view video through Apple Projected Media Profile, or APMP. You can play and stream these new immersive media formats inside your app using familiar AVKit, RealityKit, WebKit, and QuickLook APIs. And if you produce Apple immersive video content using the new Blackmagic Camera and DaVinci Resolve app, you can play it back in your apps or directly from web pages in Safari using the HTML video element. In enterprise environments, visionOS 26 makes it even easier for developers to incorporate Vision Pro into their organizations. With enterprise entitlements, you can disable content captures of your app's view, enable apps to automatically follow the user's position as they navigate a space, access the left and right camera feed simultaneously, or grab a specified region of the camera feed for stabilization and enhancement. These are just a few of the incredible features coming to visionOS.